It's not nice to eavesdrop, but it's fun. So let's check in on the comedy of errors at the Baxters. On the little things in life, brought to you by Four-Way Nasal Spray, gives you the fastest decongestant relief possible.
Perkins?
Yes, Mr. Baxter?
I'll be going over to the Hadley Company, so if anyone calls, I'll be back about 4. Did you get the letters typed up for Brazil?
Oh, they're all mailed, Mr. Baxter.
Oh, you're very efficient, Miss Perkins, and I do appreciate it.
Bob? Bob Baxter? Well, it is Bob Baxter, isn't it? Yes, it is. Hello, hello, hello. You don't remember me.
Marcia.
Aha! Oh, Bob.
Oh, Marcia, Bob. Marcia, Marcia.
I'm not even going to ask how you are. You look marvelous.
Well, you took the words right out of my mouth. No, I'm going to go even further. You're even more glamorous than you were in college.
Oh, you mean I haven't aged too much?
Oh, cut it out. You look great. But what are you doing here?
Well, I live here. In town, that is. I married Les Wilcox. He was from here, and we have the Dog and Cat Medical Center.
Oh, you did go on to be a veterinarian.
Oh, you remembered.
I remember everything about you.
Mr. Baxter, would you like me to call your wife and say you may be a bit late in case the meeting at the Hadley Company goes on too long?
Oh, what? Oh, no, Miss Perkins. Oh, boy, Marcia, you really do look great. Well, what are you doing here, though? I mean, in the building.
Well, our lawyer is on the 5th floor, and I'd heard that you were with this company on the 3rd floor, so I just took a chance and got off the elevator, came through the doors, and saw you standing there. So it's not exactly fate that we meet again.
I don't care what it is. It's wonderful to see you.
Listen, are you free tonight?
Well, sure, I think so.
Oh, fine. I'm inviting you to dinner.
Oh, well, that's very nice of you. Miss Perkins?
Yes, Mr. Baxter?
Would you put in a call to my wife?
Yes, sir, I certainly will.
You mean, Bob, that you can't have dinner with me without asking your wife? You need her permission?
What? I'm sorry. I thought you were inviting us both to your house.
Oh, heavens no. I never cook during the week. Les and I both have office hours, and actually I'm small animals, dogs and cats and birds, and he's horses and cows, and we just can't really get together until the weekends when we just flop around in old clothes, and it's the only time I do any cooking.
Oh,
I was inviting you out to have dinner with me.
Your wife is on the phone, Mr. Baxter.
Okay, Miss Perkins, just hold on a minute. Well, Marcia, wouldn't your husband, well, you know, wouldn't he mind?
About what? Oh, Bob, you have forgotten. I'm the original woman's liver.
Yes, I'll admit you're always ahead of just about everything.
Well, now, can you or can't you have dinner without asking your wife?
Well, yes, sure.
Well, when do you get through here?
Oh, I've got a meeting, and then I plan to come back to the office about 5.
Oh, that's too early for me. I've got an emergency operation, a dog with a hysterectomy, so I won't be through until about 8. Now, where could I pick you up?
At 8?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, I'm usually home by that time.
Look, is this awkward for you?
Oh, no, of course not. My wife is very open-minded.
She is also on the phone, Mr. Baxter.
Yes, okay, Miss Perkins, I'll be right there. Look, Marcia, just sit down over there, and I'll tell my wife that I'm having dinner with you, and then I'll tell you how to get out to our house.
Fine. Oh, how wonderful to see you again. Now, don't be long, because the bitch has been sedated, and I'm due there now.
The what?
Oh, darling, the dog.
Oh.
Oh, Bob, you are so funny. You always were so old-fashioned, which I think is part of your charm.
Yes, well,
Mrs. Baxter is on the phone. Shall I explain to her?
No, Miss Perkins. I'll explain. I hope.
Well, I think it's outrageous. Absolutely outrageous.
Aunt Maggie, you just...
Yes, Aunt Maggie, now just a minute. I want to get this all straight. Now, Bob, I didn't understand you on the phone, and I don't know. Now, this old girlfriend of yours...
She is not an old girlfriend.
Well, she has to be one or the other. She's not an old boyfriend.
She is just an old college friend. She and her husband have the animal hospital out in the Cedar Heights Road.
She invited you out to dinner. She's picking you up and taking you out to dinner and paying the check.
Well, yes, I guess so.
I never heard of such a thing. You're a married man, and she's a married woman.
Well, if she's going to pay the check.
I don't think that's the point at all. What does her husband say?
Look, they're both very happily married. They're both vets. They work together, and knowing Marcia, I'm sure he's quite used to her ideas on women's lib and equal rights, or he wouldn't have married her in the first place.
Bob, did she ask you if you had to have my permission to have dinner with her?
Well, no. She really didn't.
She really did. Well, I'm certainly not going to embarrass you if she puts you on the spot. You go and have a good time. You just make sure she pays the check, honey.
Well, I certainly don't approve at all.
Times have changed, Aunt Mag. It's nice to think I'm married to such an attractive man. He gets asked out on a date.
Look, are you going to make any funny remarks when Marcia gets here?
Oh, I shall be so interesting and agreeable on the subject of women's rights that she may invite me instead of you. Oh, you are really, dear, more old-fashioned than I am. Actually, you don't even want to go, do you?
Why are you urging him to go? I don't understand any of this.
You get upstairs, Bob. You shower and shave. Oh, and wear that beautiful new navy blue jacket, dear.
Oh, well, I was saving that for a special occasion.
Well, if this isn't a special occasion, I don't know what is. Now, your date's picking you up in an hour. Step on it. Comes our conquering hero down the stairs. Oh, Bob, that jacket's a knockout on you. Doesn't he look handsome, Aunt Maggie?
I'm not having any part of this at all.
Oh, your tie's a mess, dear. Here, let me fix it. You know, you're so nervous, you certainly made a shambles of it. Let me fix it up then, too.
I'm beginning to agree with Aunt Maggie. It does seem a little ridiculous, you getting me dressed up to go out on a date.
Oh, and you've got dog fur on your pant legs. Let me get the brush. There she is, Aunt Maggie. Will you get the door?
No, I will not. I'm going out in the kitchen and do our dinner dishes.
Well, you answer the door then, Bob. You want me to get it?
No. I'll go. Just please, stop brushing me off.
I'm sorry, Bob. I'm a little late, but Les and I had some complications with that operation.
No, it's right on time. I'd like you to meet my wife. Honey, this is...
Peg! It isn't.
It is. Hi, Marcy.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Oh, you look marvelous, Marcy.
Oh, so do you.
You mean you two know each other?
Well, you look great.
I never knew that you married Bob Baxter.
Well, I did. And if you're taking him out to dinner tonight, you make sure you pay the check.
Well, actually, I thought we'd go to the club. I'll just sign the check and my husband can pay the bill.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, well, could I get a word in, please?
Yes, and Marcy and I are both gamified.
But I was 3 years ahead of her in school, you see, and I was her big sister when she pledged the sorority.
Did you know all along when I came home tonight and told you that...
Yes, dear, I have to admit it. I couldn't help it. I'm sorry. I knew Marcy would appreciate the joke.
Oh, not so sure I do.
Oh,
Alex,
you just look...
What? Alex is sick.
What?
Alex?
Who's Alex, your son?
No, my dog.
Sick. He just threw up, and then he sort of toppled over, and he looks terrible.
Oh, Bob, listen, get my medical kit out of the back seat of my car.
Okay, all right. Wonderful.
For a minute, I forgot you were a vet. Where is my boy? Oh, Marcia, this is Aunt Maggie.
How do you do?
Nice to meet you.
Oh, it's all right, Aunt Maggie. Marcy's an old sorority sister of mine. I knew all along when he said Marcia Kimball. It was just... Oh, never mind. Here's my sick doggy.
Oh, well, my goodness. It didn't feel well.
It doesn't feel good. What do you think's wrong with him, Marcy?
Oh, I can't tell yet. Let's see if we can just get him on his feet, and then we'll take him in the car to the hospital. I'll get some x-rays and some blood tests.
Okay, here's the bag.
Oh, we'll put it back in the car, Bob, because we're going to take Alex to the hospital.
What about dinner?
Well, some other time. Your dog is sick. Kind of help him along, Peg.
Yes, I am.
Yes, he's a sick doggy.
Yes, Mommy's right here, darling. She's right here. Bob, don't stand in the way, honey. Can't you see Alex is having a hard enough time trying to walk?
What about dinner?
Baby.
Aunt Marcy's going to take you to the hospital and make you well.
Yes, Aunt Marcy's going to look after you.
Come on,
Alex. Oh, what luck you were here, Marcy. Come on, Mommy's here.
Boy, it's easy to see who rules the roost around here. I sure got stood up.
The dog is sick.
Well, the Lord and Master is hungry.
Well, we've eaten. Fix yourself a sandwich. I'm not going to cook for any playboy who was stepping out on his wife.
Playboy. Where's the peanut butter?
Oh.
Uncle Thaddeus, can I ask you something?
Don't ask for money.
It's this cold, Unc.
Nephew, you need four-way nasal spray.
Will it help?
Use as directed, four-way provides the fastest decongestant relief possible for stuffy noses and sinuses.
Unc, that's a blast. Is it expensive?
Bah, four-way costs a darn sight less than the leading brand. You can't buy faster relief at any price.
I'm gonna get some four-way.
Maybe you've got a nose for business after all.
Do you think all antiperspirants are basically the same? Well, ban roll-on antiperspirant may just change your mind. Take effectiveness, for instance. Tests have shown that ban roll-on antiperspirant will actually help stop wetness better than most leading sprays. Make your own test soon. Pick up a bottle of ban roll-on, and you may discover what we've shown in tests. Ban roll-on antiperspirant, proof that not all antiperspirants are created equal. The Little Things in Life, created by Peg Lynch, has been brought to you by Ban Roll-On, America's leading roll-on antiperspirant. This program comes to you from the Radio Playhouse.